Hello friends, today I am going to reveal some true facts about attention deficit hyperactivity disorder in children, commonly called ADHD disorder. But first of all, I request you to please share and subscribe my channel for getting my informative true facts videos uninterrupted. Now, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. ADHD is a neurodevelopmental disorder of childhood that is characterized by developmentally inappropriate levels of hyperactivity, impulsivity and inattention. ADHD prevalence. About 3 to 9% of the elementary school children affected by this disorder. More often in males than females, with the sex ratio being about 3:1 to 9:1. It is the most common disorder of childhood, accounting for a large number of referrals to doctors, family physicians and child mental health professionals. ADHD risk factors. Maternal cigarette use, maternal alcohol use, unusually long or short labor, forceps delivery, toxemia, meconium staining, birth during the month of September, it is important, birth during the month of September, minor physical anomalies. History of ADHD. Characteristics of this disorder have been recognized for at least a century. The disorder has been referred to by a variety of labels, that is MBD, that means minimal brain dysfunction, hyperkinetic reaction of childhood, attention deficit disorder ADD, and finally attention deficit hyperactivity disorder ADHD. In 1980s, DSM-3 and DSM-3R stimulates ADHD research. Development of new assessment methods, new treatment methods, increased focus on biological factors. In 1990s, neuroimaging, genetics and the revaluation of DSM. DSM-4 hyperactivity. Often fidgets with hands or feet, squirms in seat. ADHD disorder children often leave seat in classroom or in other situation in which remaining seated is expected. ADHD disorder children often runs about or climbs excessively in situations in which it is inappropriate. They often have difficulty playing or engaging in leisure activities quietly. The ADHD disorder children often on to go or on the go or often acts as if driven by a motor. They often talk excessively when inappropriate to the situation. 6 or more of hyperactive and or impulsive symptoms required for diagnosis. Children with ADHD are more active, restless and fidgety than normal children during the day and during sleep. There are different types of hyperactivity. There are three types of hyperactivity. Number 1, gross motor activity. Number 2, restless, squirming. Number 3, verbal hyperactivity. Hyperactivity often varies according to situation. Degree of hyperactivity may vary with age. DSM-4, impulsivity. Often blurts out answers before questions have been completed. ADHD disorder children often has difficulty awaiting turn. They often interrupts and intrudes on others. 6 symptoms of hyperactivity and impulsivity are required for diagnosis. Inattention. ADHD disorder children often fail to give close attention to details or make careless mistakes. They often has difficulty sustaining attention in tasks or play activities. ADHD disorder children often does not seem to listen when spoken to directly. ADHD disorder children often does not follow through on instructions and fails to finish homework, chores or duties in the workplace. They often has difficulty organizing tasks and activities. ADHD disorder children often avoid, dislikes or is reluctant to engage in tasks that require sustained mental efforts. They often loses things necessary for tasks or activities. Is often easily distracted by extraneous stimuli. ADHD disorder children is often forgetful in daily activities. 6 or more symptoms needed for diagnosis. Attentional problems may be most obvious on specific types of attentional tasks. Sustained attention. Responding to tasks, being vigilant. situation requiring the child to attend overtime to dull, boring and repetitive task. Diagnostic criteria. Symptoms criteria. Core symptoms of hyperactivity and impulsivity and or inattention, 6 or more symptoms of either category is important. Duration criteria. Symptoms have persisted for at least 6 months. Then we can diagnose that in this ADHD. Developmental criteria. Symptoms are inconsistent and with developmental level. Impairment criterion. Clear evidence of clinically significant impairment in social, academic or occupational functioning. Age criteria. Age. Some symptoms that cause impairment were present before age 7. Situation criteria. Some impairment from symptoms is present in 2 or more settings. Types of ADHD. Combined type. Combined type means symptoms of hyperactivity, impulsivity and inattention, all 3. Hyperactive impulsive type. Symptoms of hyperactivity and impulsivity. Predominantly inattentive type. Symptoms of inattention. Impairment in ADHD. Social impairment. What does it look like? This is a question. Academic impairment. Long-term outcomes for children with ADHD. Not so good. Family impairment. Occupational impairment. And driving impairment. ADHD across the lifespan. ADHD is a chronic disorder. Please understand, ADHD is a chronic disorder. 60% to 80% of children continues to meet diagnostic criteria in adolescence also. 50% to 70% of children will continue to meet diagnostic criteria in adulthood also. ADHD in childhood is different from adolescence and different from adulthood. Presentation of ADHD in adolescence. Adolescence phase. Gross motor activity tends to disappear. Predominance of inattention, restlessness, rather than hyperactivity and impulsivity. ADHD in adults, more similar to adolescent presentation, more similar to just like adults, mainly problems with inattention and impulsivity. How much inattention and impulsivity affect an adult male? This is a question. Occupational impairment. Similar problems to this seen in the academic environment also. Often unprepared, untimely, easily distracted. ADHD disorder persons are underachievers. Social impairment. Still there in adolescence and adulthood. If you don't attend when people talk, they often think you are not interested. Adolescents and adults with ADHD are more likely than those without being engaged in risky behavior including marijuana use, alcohol use and drunk driving. This is true even when accounting for the presence of oppositional defiant disorder and or conduct disorder. Driving impairment. Leading cause of death in 15 to 24 years old are motor vehicle accidents. Adolescents and adults with ADHD are more likely to have an accident. They are more likely to have an accident, to have more accidents. One of the most common cause of driving accident is due to ADHD. ADHD neuropsychological deficits. Results from research involving neuropsychological testing has often suggested that children with ADHD have problems inhibiting behavioral response, with working memory, with planning and organization, with verbal fluency, with preservation, with motor sequencing, and with other frontal lobe functions. Other neurological findings. Differences in cerebral blood flow. Differences in cerebral metabolism. Differences in the corpus callosum. Neurotransmitter deficits. Neurotransmitter dysfunction in children with ADHD have been suggested for many years, originated from observations of the response of children with ADHD to different types of stimulant drugs. In fact, the stimulant drugs have an impact on ADHD and that they increase. Dopamine has contributed to the neurotransmitter dysfunction hypothesis. Now, comorbidity and ADHD. Comorbidity, it is important. Comorbidities means learning abilities, then 19 to 26%. Oppositional defiant disorder 40%. Conduct disorder 25%. Children 45 to 50%. Adolescents. Anxiety disorder 30%. Depressive disorder 10 to 30%. Bipolar disorder up to 20%. And tics and Tourette's disorder 7% of children with ADHD have a tic disorder. 40 to 50% of those with Tourette's disorder have ADHD. Parents reports is very much important. Parents and teachers reports. Teachers report, and then I'm going to put teachers report. These are essential in assessing for ADHD. Need to identify impairment in multiple settings. Most children with ADHD will have academic impairment. Teachers may have the best knowledge of developmentally appropriate levels because they work with so many children. Teachers reporting important. There is a teacher version of the CPRS report called the Conner's Teachers Rating Scales. It is modified for the classroom setting but is scored in the same way. There are also teachers equivalent of broadband measures. Parents report is also essential for the ADHD detection. Now the treatment factor, treatment of ADHD. ADHD treatment, stimulant medications, other medications, psychosocial treatments, and educational accommodations. Stimulant medications, some drugs are there, that is Ritalin, Dexedrine, Adderall, Concreta. 70 to 80% of children with ADHD respond well to stimulant drugs. Stimulant drugs represent an empirically supported treatment for core symptoms of ADHD. Stimulants are a trial and error method. It has a side effect of stimulants, loss of appetite, weight loss, sleeping problems, irritability, restlessness, stomach, headache, rapid heart rate, elevated blood pressure, shortened duration of behavior. Symptoms of depression with sadness, crying, and withdrawal behavior. Actually, a stimulant drug is not the answer of ADHD. There are so many side effects. It has also long-term effect also. Side effects are often transient in nature, result of inappropriate medications levels. If one medication results in side effect, another might be used without side effects. Other medications are used to minimize side effects. But side effect is there in all the medicines. Psychosocial treatments, parent training, social skill training, cognitive behavioral treatment, psychotherapy for combined conditions, needs for multimodal treatment, educational interventions is important. So special education services for existing learning problems, classroom accommodations, classroom behavior modification program is important. The daily report card, a specific set of behavior relevant to the specific child, a specific set of behaviors relevant to the specific child. Everyday teachers mark how the child did on these behaviors. What are the reactions of the children with ADHD? Child is rewarded or not based on performance at school. Integrates the classroom and home. It is essential to treat the full range of difficulties that impact on child and family functioning. Treatment of ADHD needs to be multimodal. Findings from the multimodal treatment study suggest that the stimulant medication is effective in reducing core symptoms, but it is not permanently cured. But it cannot be permanently cured. Psychosocial treatments are available in addressing associated comorbidities. In my next video, I will give you some more benefits for ADHD.